welcome back to my channel. So today basically we are just talking, having conversations here, about the effects of coronavirus on your mental health. Yeah, so mental health is really an important aspect, and it ranges from like anxiety, depression, specific phobias, schizophrenia or madness. Yeah, so during this time of the outbreak, there are so many like mixed emotions everywhere. People are feeling hopeless, people are anxious. So let's discuss that in depth. When it comes to anxiety, I've realized that people are so anxious about maybe my job security, like if I don't go to work for maybe this period of time, I can lose my job. Then maybe if I have a business, I'll lose out on maybe my business, I won't have money. Yeah, so such kinds of anxiety. I also have a mindset of maybe I was living this life before, now I'll have to survive. Yeah, it's totally like relatable. Maybe someone is affected. For example, when I was thinking like, yeah, in my previous video, when I was thinking that I'm going to have corona, man, that anxiety is, it's so bad. And if you have now maybe those symptoms and you're showing that, you're bound to be anxious, like, if I have corona, maybe I'm gonna die, this is going to happen to me. So many people have died, and yeah, you see such anxiety, it's not really nice. And then another one, we have depression. So there's feelings of hopelessness, like people are feeling like, hey, this is the end of the world, this is going to happen, this is gonna happen. So if you look at people's mental health right now, it's not good. And then the fact that there's that social withdrawal and quarantine, so you can't interact with friends, you can't hang out with people because of maybe a lockdown or you're restricted to move. Yeah, and then that aspect of also loneliness, maybe you're just one child in your family and right now you're not even near your friends, your parents, you're staying alone, so you'll most definitely be bound to be depressed. And then also, for example, for someone who has maybe pre-existing depression or maybe pre-existing anxiety disorder, and then now this whole issue comes up, it can trigger your depression or it can trigger your anxiety even more. Yeah, and then there's hysteria, people are having panic attacks here and there. Sorry. So yeah, there's so many. So for example, you watch the news, then you're like, what, man, 500 people more have died in Italy, how many people have been infected? And then people are just having like panic attacks here and there. You've seen the effects of coronavirus on mental health. How do we reduce that? Even the fact that you're self-quarantined, first of all, there's some measures that you can take. You can choose to have fun with yourself. Yeah, you can watch movies. So if people who work from 8 to 5 and you never have time to watch movies, this is the time. Discover what movies you like. Go to Netflix, go to those other sites. Watch movies, they'll distract you. Then you can also do some exercise. Guys are asking me, since right now we cannot go to our gym, how do we go about it? So you can just go to YouTube, type home workouts, type Zumba, type aerobics. You can dance, you can have fun at home in the house. You don't have to go to the gym. Yeah, and then there's the power of prayer also. Yeah, there's just that peace that comes with praying. When you pray, everything goes well. And then don't avoid spreading wrong information. I've realized that people are just giving out wrong information, which is causing more and more panic. So stop dishing out wrong information. Make sure the information that you give is either WHO approved or even CDC. So just don't go spreading around like information you just get here, you copy paste. No, you're making people to panic. And then if you're predisposed to maybe having panic attacks, distract yourself and stop watching like frequent news about coronavirus and stuff. Though it's good to get informed, but if you're having those panic attacks, I'd advise distract yourself, don't watch news, yeah, like that. And then meditate. You can go to a place like right now, you can just go like down the river there, I sit, I just meditate and think this is the time to reflect on your life. This is the time to reflect on your choices as an individual. Take it as this time, and then also you can read your favorite book, read a magazine, do what you actually don't usually do. And I've seen people are like, oh, this is the time we are supposed to discover what introverts are doing. So if you have an introvert friend, video call them, text them and ask them, yo, what do you do for fun? You can try and incorporate that. Yeah, so I hope you stay safe. I hope you'll take care of your mental health. Advise also other people to take care of their mental health. It will come and go, just like other pandemics have come and like disappeared. Yeah, it will come and go. So reassure other people, and if you have like an older person who has a condition, please protect them and just tell them it will come and go, nothing serious, don't worry about that. Yeah, so also practice these measures that I've talked about in my previous videos, and yeah, just stay safe and take care. Bye.